Hello and welcome to a new video here on my channel here at commaike. In this video, I want to introduce you to the Reolink RLC 1240A dome camera. What makes this camera special is that, unlike many other models, it doesn't offer just 8 megapixels or 4K resolution, but 12 megapixels. So it has an extremely high resolution, allowing you to clearly recognize license plates and faces even from a great distance. In addition, this camera has an IK10 certification. That means this device is shatterproof and vandal-resistant. Whether the advertising promises really hold up, and whether this device is worth the money, you'll find out in this video. I'll show you how to set up the camera, how to install it, how to add it to the app, and how to access the recordings. If you're interested in that, definitely stay tuned, because we're about to get started. With 4512x 2512 pixels, which is a total resolution of 12 megapixels, this camera delivers a razor-sharp image. I already have the RLC 1240A installed up there as a regular 12.12A bullet camera, and now I've also received the dome version from Reolink. This version is aimed at anyone who needs to install the camera within reach of potential perpetrators. You need protection against theft and vandalism. That's what this device is made for, with an IK10 certified dome. This means that even strong impacts with tools can't harm this dome. No scratches, no smudges, and the thing is screwed in really solidly. You can tell by the material, no one is going to steal this from you anytime soon. First, I'll show you the device up close in the office, and then I'll demonstrate how you can install it in the client on your computer and in the app on your phone. After that, I'll show you some nice images that I took with this camera here on my test property in the garden. Here it is, the RLC 1240A, a camera that stands out in two particular ways. On the one hand, it delivers true 12 megapixel resolution and is IK10 certified against vandalism. We'll take a look at exactly what that means and how it differs from other cameras step by step. Let's start with the resolution. The RLC 1240A records videos at 45x2512 pixels. That's a total of 12 megapixels. For comparison, a standard full HD camera only has about 2 megapixels and a modern 4K camera delivers around 8 megapixels. So with 12 megapixels, you get about 50% more image information than with a 4K recording, and you can really see the difference. Especially with objects that are farther away or with small details, you can zoom in without any problem. You can also zoom in on the footage later and really see what's hidden behind those details. That's a clear difference compared to 4K. The lens has a focal length of 2.8 millimeters and an aperture of 1.6. This allows for an especially wide field of view of about 145 degrees diagonally. With this, you can cover fairly large areas like a house wall, an entrance area, a carport area, and so on. So in the end, you only need one camera instead of two to monitor the same area. Most other cameras only manage about 90 to 100 degrees. So overall, you need fewer devices. A real highlight is also the IK10 certification. This designation is the highest level of impact resistance for surveillance cameras. An IK10 means that this housing can withstand an impact of 20 joules. That's comparable to a strong blow from a hard object such as a hammer or an iron bar. In practice, this means you can install the cameras in places where vandalism might occur and the camera will still be protected. If you just take a look here, you can see there's not a scratch, not a mark, nothing on it. This dome isn't made of glass either. It feels more like plastic. It's some kind of plastic material, but in any case, it's extremely sturdy. You can install the camera in places where vandalism occurs and where someone might want to destroy the camera. Thanks to the solid metal housing, it's also protected against theft. It's very difficult to steal it by ripping it off. This makes the camera quite interesting for professional use as well. The RLC 1240A also has a lot to offer when it comes to night vision. For classic infrared night vision, you have two infrared LEDs at 850 nanometers, allowing you to illuminate nearly 30 meters. But you can't really get much more than that. Alternatively, you can also use the integrated spotlights. Each of them has 3 watts with a light temperature of about 3000 K. This allows you to produce a color image even in complete darkness, because these LED spotlights illuminate the surroundings quite well. This way, you can capture the color of clothing, vehicles, or whatever else is happening that you want to record. The camera also features a two-way audio system. On the one hand, you have a built-in microphone to hear what's happening outside, and on the other, a speaker to talk to the other side. The classic example, telling the mail carrier to just leave the package there because you're not at home, of course works with this camera as well. The power supply is provided either via PoE, meaning directly through a powered network cable, or through the 12V connection. This makes installation relatively simple, and above all, you don't need to run any additional cables or anything like that. In the end, a single network cable is enough to transmit data from the camera and supply it with power at the same time. Speaking of data transfer, you can of course also store the recordings either on an SD card, the camera accepts up to 256GB maximum, or you can save the data on your NVR, your home hub, or in the cloud. All of these options are available to you. If you store it directly on the camera, you can use either Reolink's memory cards, for example this 128GB card or a 256GB card. The important thing is that the write speed is high enough and that the cards can withstand the temperature fluctuations the camera is exposed to. What can you actually record? You have motion detection and 24/7 continuous recording. You can set schedules and also use a time-lapse function. Yes, you heard right, time-lapse. That means you can set in the camera's menu that over a specific period you can freely define. The camera will repeatedly take small snapshots which are then compiled into a complete time-lapse video. This way, for example, you can beautifully capture the construction of a house or a sunrise, sunset, cloud movements, and so on. None of that is a problem. If you're interested in learning more, take a look at the top right corner. There you'll find my playlist. For all the cameras I've tested over time, I've also provided night shots. I've created all of these night shots exclusively using this time-lapse function. That way, you can get an idea, first, how good is the night quality, and second, what does a time-lapse recording actually look like. Maybe that's something I could use for a completely different project. And once you're in the playlist, it's best to also check out the video description. There you'll find lots more information about this camera, as well as Reolink's promo links so you can buy the device directly. You'll also find other links from me there, for example for PoE switches, the necessary cables, just click on them and buy if you like. No disadvantage for you and a small commission for my channel. Thanks in advance. If you've enjoyed it so far, don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss anything. Because here's a little spoiler, just like with all the other cameras, there will be a huge giveaway for this camera again at Christmas, where you can win a new camera every day, but only for my subscribers. All in all, the Reolink RLC 1240A is a camera that stands out especially for its high image quality and its durability. In the next step, I'll show you the installation process outside in my garden, and then I'll include some test recordings that I'll make and play here in the video, as you're already familiar with. A little tip from me, before you mount the camera at its intended location, you should install it beforehand, specifically on your network. With a PoE camera, that's relatively simple. I've already made a video about this. Take a look at the top right corner, I'll link it for you there. The short version for setting it up on the network is, you take your network cable from the PoE switch and simply plug it into the adapter socket here. Afterwards, you set up the camera in the client you can see behind me right now, or alternatively in the app. In other words, you enter the password for the camera. Then you can fine-tune the settings, adjust the image settings, and so on. I've already made a separate video about that as well. I won't go into more detail about that in this video, but I will show you later how I install the camera outside in my garden. I'll show you how I managed to position the camera correctly so that it actually records what I want to film. But enough talk, let's head out to the garden and I'll show you how I mount the device on my wooden shelf. Let's move on to the next step of installing the camera, mounting it. The camera has three screw holes on the back, which are used to attach the camera to the wall. To access the screw holes and screw something through them, you first need to remove the dome, of course. I've already loosened these three Allen screws that are attached here, but I haven't removed them yet because I want to show you something else first. The camera can be mounted directly on the wall. Here, you have a bit of space to position the cable accordingly. And then you can run this cable directly through the wall. The length, a wall that's 36cm thick, should just about work. I'm not a big fan of that. I prefer to use these installation boxes, like this one here. This isn't an original Reolink box. And there's really not much to complain about with the box. I use them very often, for example, for the TrackMix camera or the Elite X Pro. The cameras can be mounted directly using the various screw holes, and the cable whip can be coiled up and neatly stored inside these boxes. It looks tidy and, above all, protects the cable connection from rain, weather, and of course vandalism. However, these small boxes that I've used so far, the B10 boxes or the no-name boxes, do not fit the Reolink dome cameras. I think you can see that quite well here when I show the size comparison. Here I have the two screws and a mounting plate. If I hold it up to it now, the hole spacing doesn't fit. It's much smaller. You might need a D20 box for that. Those are the junction boxes for the dome cameras. If you have any experience with this, feel free to leave me a comment under the video because I haven't dealt with these parts at all yet. Give me some feedback on whether the D20 boxes fit perfectly for the RLC 1240A or the other dome cameras. All right, let's continue with the script. I'm now going to open this one remaining screw. By the way, the Allen key is included in the package. What I really like is that the screws are secured against falling out. You can see it here now, they're still sticking out, they don't fall through, and even the dome itself is secured with a cord so nothing else can happen. And now you have the inside of the camera here, this is what it looks like, and maybe you can see it. There's a degree indicator built in here, and you have the option to rotate the camera. It's not much, but I can rotate it by a few degrees. By loosening this screw on the side, I can also adjust the tilt. I've now attached the Reolink RLC 1240A to the junction box. I secured it in the pre-drilled holes with just one screw. I attached the cover to the junction box with two screws. Inside, the cable whip is neatly stowed away. You can't see it. It's well protected against vandalism. This is just a temporary setup. Of course, you should use several screws when installing it yourself. Now I can align the camera to cover the area I want to film. I simply use my smartphone for this. I had already set up the camera, and now you can see the live image. This way I can adjust the camera's height, tilt, and angle so that what I want to see is actually in the frame. What really doesn't work though is panning to the right or left. That doesn't work. You can only rotate the camera and tilt it up or down. You need to be aware of that. If you need a different perspective, you'll have to mount the housing at a different angle. That's why you should set up the camera in advance and hold it loosely against the wall. That way you can see if it fits and how it works best. I've already done all of that here. My last step will be as follows. I'm going to screw the dome back onto the camera. This is relatively easy to do using the three Allen screws. You should definitely make sure there are no greasy fingerprints or dirt on the dome, otherwise you'll see that later in the video. I can always wipe the outside, but the inside of the dome should definitely be clean. Let's move on to the conclusion for the RLC 1240A. This dome camera has basically convinced me, but there is one disadvantage, and in my opinion, it's quite significant. The camera has a razor-sharp resolution. I can see things very, very clearly. I can zoom in on images afterwards from a distance and recognize details. The quality is really very, very good. I have no complaints there. The black and white recordings at night are also razor-sharp. They definitely convinced me. I actually prefer the black and white recordings over those colored night shots. And that's exactly where the problem lies. When the camera switches to color night vision and activates the LED spotlight, there are reflections. The dome reflects the light inside. On the left and right, you see blurry areas and can't really make anything out. If I leave the spotlight off and the camera runs in black and white mode by default, it works perfectly. At the bottom left, as you might see in the footage, there was still a slight haze. But apart from that, it worked really, really well. After consulting with Reolink, I was informed that this is basically a fundamental issue with these dome cameras. As long as the lens inside the dome is aligned at 90 degrees, there are no problems. The lens is shielded from the dome by a rubber seal. But as soon as you move the lens a bit, and that's the whole point that I want to film at a slight downward angle, then you get this reflection. So what does that mean in reverse? If you place great value on color night vision, if you want the LED spots to illuminate the area for color recording, then this camera isn't for you. In my considered opinion, you most likely won't be truly happy with it, primarily because the reflections are simply far too strong. If black and white recordings captured at night are sufficiently adequate for you, you've undoubtedly seen the sample images in my video, then this particular camera is definitely a very good option. With the IK10 certification, this impact-resistant dome, and the solid mounting on wood or on the wall, you also have a camera that can definitely be used in semi-professional settings or in industrial facilities. The likelihood that someone will steal or destroy your camera is significantly lower than with a bullet camera. Those can be ripped off quickly if someone gets close. So what does that mean for my conclusion? Well, as I already said, if black and white is enough for you, like it is for me, then this is a good camera. For example, I have the Reolink RLC 12-120A. This 12MP bullet camera is almost identical in design. I was so impressed by it that I actually have two of them in use. I can definitely recommend this camera, but for anyone who wants color night recordings, no, stay away from it. You'd be better off getting the bullet version, the RLC 1212A. It simply takes better color images at night. I hope my video was helpful to you. I hope I was able to make your decision easier. You've seen the footage. If you have any questions for me, just leave a comment under the video. Give my video a like, subscribe to my channel. And if you want to know where to get this camera and also the other cameras that Reolink provides me with, you have two options. Option one is to buy it immediately. Just check the description below the video. There, I'll link the camera and the accessories you need. And option two is the giveaway. You know, all the cameras will be raffled off to my subscribers at the end of the season. So subscribe to my channel. That way you won't miss the giveaway video and you'll hopefully be in the draw. I'm looking forward to your feedback on this camera and on my video. Leave me a comment and give me a like. See you in the next video. Take care. Bye.